silver watch, the sound of a bell, and a sort of shadow.
A glint of silver and a tone. Hey, I must say, you look very tired.
Yes, I am so very, very tired.
Now you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
Now I'm going to do a little job of work for you.
You've cost me a bit of money, mate. So I think it's only fair that you replenish my coffers with donations from the good people of London. You will steal money for me, won't you?
Yes. I will steal money for you.
I'm warning you!
Still is in the top of the box!
Let's see how long your innards are!
Come on in, me!
Oi! Get away from me, you dodger!
Very good. Now, we can't have criminals like you roaming the streets. You will surrender to the police, won't you?
Yes. I will surrender to the police.
Oh, and when you do, you're going to do a silly little dance for them.
Gave me a terrible fright. Much
wondering about a man named Ezio.
Ezio Capelli. Not a demon, but a hypnotist.
Take anything made of silver.
We mustn't allow anyone to get near Mr. Capelli.
Mr. Capelli says I won't remember this when I'm finished.
That's close enough!
Get your hands off me!
I admit it! I'm not Italian! It was just for my act! Nobody wanted to see a British hypnotist!
Now, shut up!
I'll give you anything you want!
I want you to shut your mouth. Do you know a Dr. John Elliotson?
Never heard of the man.
Did you really think mesmerism would work?
How dare you! I'm a hypnotist! body doesn't bend that way! Game!
Time to confess and free the people under your silly spell.
Dear. This is going very badly, isn't it?
It certainly doesn't have the makings of a ripping good novel.
What happened here?
Ah! The charming and delightful Frye twins.
Have we met?
Mr. Raymond knows everyone. He knows everything about this city. He writes it all up in his books.
I'm Henry Raymond, writer of third-rate lurid stories. Penny dreadfuls, if you will. And this is little Artie.
Mr. Raymond takes real murders and makes them so awfully exciting. The guilty always get caught.
There's one unfolding just here. Perhaps one of you would like to try your hand in solving it.
So delightfully entertaining, don't you? I mean, solving crimes, of course. Finding a solution is exhilarating.
I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work. I arrived to find the foreman dead, and the lad Dooley with bloody hands. No one's been able to find the murder weapon and arrest the murderer. Could you sort it out quickly? It's holding up the work. They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
Me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under me and grab it. I lift my hands to protect myself, and he knocks me out with a punch. Later on, I wakes up, and the man's lying there, dead. He knocks me to the ground and give me a kick. I find my work knife under... me? No!
Oh, no, not so quickly. You have indeed solved this murder, according to the facts at hand. However, Artie, what advice would you give?
I would encourage you to look beyond the obvious, beyond surface appearances.
Try again. Use your powers to peer more deeply and see what you can discover.
When I come back, the man's lying dead, and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him. I was standing there, having a think, when a fella come at me and give me a thumping. Dooley tries to stop him, and he thrashes Dooley. I run out to find help. When I come back, the man's lying dead, and there's Dooley holding a knife. Please don't arrest him.
I should go back and ask about this.
Re-examine some of the clues more closely. About this.
Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming. Wilkins went to see what it was about and never come back. I went to see for myself, and there he was, dead. I didn't stick around. Somebody might think I'd done it. The strange thing is, Wilkins weren't wearing no bandana when I was talking to him. Only the workmen in the brewery wear bandanas. You should talk to Morris there. Me and Wilkins was working out here. We heard screaming.
Re-examine some of the clues more closely.
Well, I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man asked to, what with all the smells and fumes. Well, I was inside the brewery all day. I wear me bandana in there. Man asked to, what with all the smells and fumes. Well, I was inside...
Fumes can be a bit much in the brewery. When the men work in there, they wear bandanas. Wilkins wasn't the type to beat the children. On the contrary, he was forever getting in fights, trying to stop that sort of thing. They're a rough bunch, but someone has to keep the kids in line. I just wish the grown-ups would quit fighting each other.
He's my brother. He don't like to work hard, so one of the workers give him a thrashing. I tried to stop it, and he stops it in bark and starts it in me. Enoch's...
Try to establish a motive.
That's Dooley's knife, all right. He never lent it to nobody.
Establish a motive.
Now that I've seen this, I should ask more questions. I wonder if someone could tell me more about this.
I don't much know who smokes here. Maybe Taylor? Cigarette might be his.
Re-examine some of the clues more closely.
Quit smoking months ago. You know, I saw somebody from the brewery having a smoke this morning. Didn't see who it was, though.
Well, like I said, I was inside. Didn't get a chance to come out to smoke. Colton left, though. You could talk to him. He's working in the loading area just now.
Try to establish a motive.
Well now, I didn't ask about this.
I don't smoke. Never did. I should be foreman here.
That was much more difficult than it initially appeared. Well done.
Up to the clink with you!
You seem tired, friend. Everything all right?
No rest for the wicked, Charlie.
Today's Ghost Club investigation involves
dead letters.
It's said to be covered with gold leaf, dazzling passers-by when the sun shines. Naturally, it's rumored to be haunted. Now let's see if we can find it.
I presume this was once used to carry the mail. Oh, that actually looks remarkably comfortable. Yes, madam. Don't worry. You're safe.
Oh, you saved me. That wretch would have forced me to marry him within the hour. I must return home.
Thank you.
lost them. Thank you, you have been a great help. Will you please take me home? I owe you my thanks. You have gone to a great deal of trouble for someone you don't even know. What is your name?
Jacob Frye, miss.
And saved my life. I am Elizabeth. Won't you climb down and sit beside me so that I might see your face?
Miss? Where are you?
You look as though you're just about to collapse. What on earth has happened?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
No, it wasn't me. Not guilty. Beg your pardon. You're the one.
I assure you we've never met.
Is this a prize fighting ring?
You bet your eyes and ears it is, my lord. Milady. The name's Robert Topping. Best bookie in all of London at your disposal. Well, second best, but my mum says Don's a bit of a nincompoop. Anyhow, I can show you a vast array of exciting things. From prize fights to carriage races.
I think we can afford to spend a little time here.
Thank you.
grace the ring with your presence again. With your presence again. My lord. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new champion!
this is... My God, this is Michel Rouge's vault!
Michael Rouge's vault? It can't be.
You have no idea who that is, do you?
I'm the foggiest.
He was an assassin. Father had one of his books. Legend says he found some fabulous treasure near Bath that drove him mad. He locked it away beneath London, in a vault that could only be opened by a set of special musical boxes.
Special musical boxes? Now who's mad?